Hi, this is Shreyas from Shine My Right. So today we are going to do some myth busting of what ceramic is, what graphene is, and what usually you've been hearing of in the market. And in a lot of YouTube videos, people have made a lot of wild comments and wild promises about ceramic coating. So I have a few common questions listed out. So let me quickly go through these questions. So first, how many layers of ceramic will you apply on my car? Firstly, ceramic cannot be applied in layers. Ceramic coating is a treatment of your clear coat. So there are four layers: clear coat, base coat, primer, and metal. So on top of clear coat, we do conditioning of the clear coat. We make the clear coat absolutely smooth, spick and span. Then we apply ceramic coating. Once we apply ceramic coating, it's not a separate layer from your clear coat. It is actually a treatment of your clear coat. So once the treatment is done, it's done. It's like a moisturizer which you apply on your face, on your skin. Once you moisturize the face, it's moisturized. Now after every 30 minutes you keep on applying the cream, it's all waste. So similarly, if you do ceramic coating on the clear coat, it is applied, it is left to cure, and that's it. So you cannot keep on adding layers and layers and layers. You cannot make a building out of it. It doesn't make any sense. If someone's telling you we do in layers, please run away. He's actually just trying to charge you more. We don't apply any layers. We don't promise you any layers. We will apply a single layer. We will ensure 100% coverage of the panel. That's why we do it two times. So once we apply, maybe in a horizontal fashion, then we do in a vertical fashion, whatever the panel size is, whatever the direction of the panel is, we do it twice only to ensure that we don't skip any of the edges of the panel. But we don't do any layering because you cannot do any layers in ceramic or graphene coating. Coming to the next question. I want to do PPF coating, but I want to do ceramic also. Again, if someone's telling you I can do ceramic and PPF on your car, please run away. He's only running after your money. He's making a fool out of you. Number one, let us understand what is ceramic and what is PPF. Ceramic is a treatment of your clear coat. So once that treatment is done, ceramic will ensure that nothing comes and sticks on your clear coat, right? Ceramic will ensure there is absolutely clarity, there is absolutely nice shine to your clear coat. Now once I am saying that there will be nothing sticking on the clear coat with ceramic coating, how will I stick PPF on top of it? Doesn't make sense, right? So you cannot do both the things together. Yes, there are certain PPF films of good brands like Lumar, like Garvare, which have a pre-coated PPF from the factory. So you can apply those films directly. So a detailer will do a paint correction of your clear coat and apply PPF on top of it. With that PPF, which is already pre-coated from the factory, will be good for your car because it will add certain amount of shine to it. But if someone's saying I'll do ceramic and then I'll apply PPF on top of it, or if someone's saying I'll apply PPF and on top of it I'll do ceramic coating, he's fooling you. That is not possible. That is just a money-making scheme. Right, let's come to the third topic. Should I do ceramic coating now since my car is new, or should I wait for some time? See, ceramic is actually protection of your clear coat, so the earlier you start, the better. It's like vaccination. So when kids are small, we do vaccination as soon as possible when the right time comes. With cars, the right time is day one. Since it has come from the factory, it is already delivered to you from the showroom, already certain damages have happened on the paint, on the clear coat, please get it done as soon as possible. It will protect your paint from day one. So fourth question, and a very common question, is can I do 10H or 11H ceramic or graphene coating on my car? Okay, let us understand a very simple thing. If I have a scale which can measure, let's say, about 2 feet, right? Now with this scale, can I measure 10 feet or can I measure 3 feet? You can say I can measure 2 feet first and then I can do a further 3 feet, but this is length, and what we are talking about is hardness. 9H and 10H and 11H is all hardness. Now when my hardness scale is from 9B to 9H, which is B is softest and H is hardest. When the scale itself cannot go beyond 9H, how am I going to measure 10H? There are very, very specialized tools, specialized labs in specifically in European countries where they can measure 10H and 11H, but it is not viable for coatings. We need to understand we are not doing any big rocket science or any big metal enhancement of your paint. We are simply trying to protect the clear coat. So we cannot invest so much technology in only enhancing the clear coat. If it was so beneficial and if it was so easy, the OEMs would have done it already, right? So 10H and 11H are all false claims. Even 9H achieving actually on the surface is highly impossible. Yes, the coatings are good. The coatings give you a good hardness. The coatings will prevent your paint from any external damages. Before paint getting damaged, the coating itself will get damaged. So that's like a barrier between your clear coat and your external environment. But there is nothing called as 10H or 9H. Please don't fall into such things. Please be very clear with your detailer. I only want a basic coating to protect the paint. Don't go into the hardness factor of those coatings. Also, the fifth myth is that do you have IR lights or heating is required for curing of ceramic coating? So please understand, we are in Mumbai and by God's grace, always the temperature is above 15-20 degrees Celsius. So the technical requirement is for 12 hours at 20 degrees Celsius. We have to keep the car for perfect curing. Now by default, what we do is in the evening, we complete the coating by about 7-8 o'clock. We close the studio and for 14 hours, any which ways the car is protected inside the studio. And by God's grace, always the temperature is going to be around 20-25-30 degrees. So in that atmosphere, automatically the curing happens. IR blasters or IR lights are good for places where it's very cold, like in European countries, or maybe if you're doing detailing in Shimla or Kashmir, or you know, those hilly areas where the temperature is usually around 10-12 degrees, then you need IR blasters. For Mumbai, I don't think it's required. So I hope I was able to answer most of your myths, and please don't fall for any of the false marketing gimmicks which are happening around the world. Please do your research. Please go to a good educated detailer who can actually explain to you in detail and actually show you the process. Don't go only for YouTube videos or Instagram reels. Please understand what the process is and please understand the science behind it, the technology involved behind all these coatings, and then pay for the coatings.